Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Wake Up Missoula. I am your host, Scott Ramph, and I'm here to talk about a whole bunch of wonderful things that are happening, especially here at MCAT. I got a lot of new programs from Montana Book Festival, State of Missoula's Chamber of Commerce talk where they're talking about entrepreneurship and their workshops. I also got jail diversion programs on MCAT that's been airing on last night, but of course you can watch it pretty much anytime on MCAT. There's the community lecture series kick off this week, along with many other lecture series that will be happening. I believe that there's going to be Global Public Health Series, the Wilderness Issues Lecture Series, Mansfield Brown Bay Lecture Series, the Presidential Lecture Series, the Provost Lecture Series, all sorts of lecture series for you guys. We got some, I got a new stop motion for you guys. MCAT has some new equipment for you guys. I'll talk about it. It's a virtual reality thing, and I think it's going to be really great. I'll talk more about it, and I have some visuals for you guys later on in the show. I have all sorts of news and events for you guys to kind of keep you guys going throughout the next couple of days. And I got Aaron Robertson here from Barnard School talking about Hooked on Art happening this Saturday, and I'll have her talk more about this. But first, let's throw it to some weather. So, of course, if you haven't already noticed, the snow is coming back with a vengeance. It is currently 24 degrees outside. Your high is going to be 31 degrees. Your low is going to be 26 degrees. Snow is likely today, so you have that 70% chance. Thursday, you have a higher chance of rain, freezing rain, with a high of 45 degrees. So things are getting warmer, but you still have that chance of freezing rain, fog overnight. Your low is going to be 29, and then you can expect your Friday to be just as warm and cold and chilly and rain and freezing as tomorrow. But today you can expect a nice fluffy light snow. So if you guys are planning on doing anything today, with some snowing or skiing or anything like that, today might be the day for it, the middle of the week, because by the time weekend comes around, you may not get that fresh powder as people always sought after. But in terms of slopes, Whitefish Mountain Ski Resort had 18 inches in the last 72 hours. Blacktail Mountain Ski Area had 12 inches in the last 24 hours. Big Sky Resort had 6 inches. Trenton Ski Pass hasn't had any. Bridger Bowl, 9 inches. Snow Bowl, they've gotten 5 inches in the last 72 hours, but that's sure to change. Lost Trail, you had 5 inches in the last 72 hours. It says that all their trails are open. Discovery Ski Area had 4 inches in the last 72 hours. And finally, Showdown Montana had about 2 inches in the last 72 hours. And I got that information from onthesnow.com. You can find out more information about your weather from going on to the nationalweatherservice.gov, where I found it. Moving on, here is some news events that are happening. As I mentioned earlier, as healthcare hasn't become a huge topic in the nation, the 19th annual community lecture series has started and has been tackling this particular and is going to be tackling this particular topic in terms of health, wellness, mental illness, all sorts of things. I have a clip from the very first series. It was from last night, and it features Reed Thumper, and he's talking about. And then his topic was Mythbusters, health, wellness, longevity, and the prevention of chronic illness. I have a nice little short clip from him, and here it is.
You might remember Jean-Louis Calment, who does have the record, if you want to call it a record, I guess, for the longest documented living individual. And you might remember the story. Some of you will remember the story about Jean-Louis. Jean-Louis, who died at 122, this is her 121st birthday, obviously, blow out those candles. But when she was 90, lived in Paris, she had a flat in Paris. She had no heirs to leave her flat to. So apparently it's customary that in situations like that, you can sell your flat to someone and they pay you a monthly rent until such time that you pass away. And then that person assumes ownership of the flat. So she sold it to a 47-year-old individual, André Raffet. So André Raffet started making his payments to Ms. Calment when he was 47 and she's 90. Now, come on, you got to believe. Everyone in here has got to believe, like, this has got to be a good deal for me. I'm 47, she's 90. What's the worst that could happen? She went to his funeral. Of course, he died at 77 of cancer, unfortunately. So he only lived another 30 years. But for 30 years, he paid rent to Ms. Calment as she aged to 100, 110, 120. When she attended his funeral, they asked her about it, and her response was, and you can look it up, she said her response was, "Sometimes in life, you just make bad deals."
All right, so that was a nice little anecdote from our very first community lecture series talking about health and wellness. The one thing that I definitely took away from doing that shoot last night is that a person of medium weight and no activity has the same life expectancy as somebody with who's overweight who is active, which is crazy. So that's the one thing I definitely took away from that, wellness, longevity, and just talking about what it means to be healthy in today's society. Up next, I got some more events. So of course, if you haven't heard in the state, here's something for you guys, for you out there who are nonprofits looking to cash in or get some extra money. David Glazier from Missoula, he went over to Billings to talk about a $80 million tax credit he wishes to invest in the nonprofit sector, particularly to help developers finance projects to improve blighted neighborhoods. In November, the group learned it was receiving $90 million worth of tax credits from the U.S. Treasury, the largest award for a regional group in the country. With $10 million already committed to, Glazier said that he is seeking additional project funds. He said, "We have free money for projects that are eligible in Montana. You should call me." Glazier, president of the Missoula-based Montana and Idaho Community Development Corporation, told a group of about 30 lenders and business leaders in Billings the other day. I got this from the Billings Gazette. If you are a developer involved with redevelopment agencies and you are a nonprofit that wishes to get some of this $80 million, you can email Dave G at mtcdc.org. There you go. Free money for nonprofits out there. In the national news, of course, if you haven't already heard, the Patriots won the Super Bowl with a 25-point from behind upset in a thrilling game. Most folks were already saying that the Atlanta Falcons had it in the bag by halftime. For a team not only to have a comeback but put a game together into overtime, which is completely the first in Super Bowl history, 51 games, no one went overtime, and no one had a major comeback as much as the Patriots did. When there is a blowout, it usually stays a blowout. The one thing is for sure that Coach Bill Belichick isn't afraid of is choking. So just be aware that's kind of the things. And of course, most of you, a lot of times, not only is it a tradition to watch the football game, but it's also a tradition to watch the Super Bowl ads. I'm not going to show you any of the ads, but there was a really weird Spuds McKenzie ad that just kind of like was interesting. It was kind of like a Christmas Carol, but with like a dog that was like a ghost telling this going guy is like, "You should go out and drink," which I don't know when a ghost tells you that you should go out and drink. It's kind of like disconcerting because how did that dog become a ghost in the first place? All right, that's about it. I have Ann Robinson coming on. She's going to be talking about Hooked on Art. But, of course, I do have an art clip from the Mizzou Art Museum to get you pumped up for this weekend for the Hooked on Art happening at Bonner School. And I'll have Aaron Robertson talk more about this when we come back. Hey guys, I'm here with Erin Robertson, and she is here to talk about Hooked on Art. And we have a nice little poster to kind of like show it, so if you want to kind of hold this up for everybody.
This amazing poster was done by my good friend Amber Bushnell. This is the second year that she's made an awesome poster for us. She's a great graphic designer, and on the poster you can see that Jack Metcalf's artwork is here. He is coming to talk to us at 1 o'clock in the afternoon during Hooked on Art. Jack is kind of our local celebrity artist that will be out there talking about his artwork in relation to Walter Hook. And at noon, we have a free art class for kiddos. And all day long from 10 to 4, we'll have art in the gym and art market. And we have live music and dance. We have some current and former Bonner School kiddos performing. We also have some younger little kiddos coming to play guitar for a couple hours, and Casey Schaefer of the Whiz Pops. And Andrea Harsell is going to come out and play some music for us, and it is just going to be a jam-packed day of art and music. Super fun.
Great.
And empanadas all day long, too, from the empanada joint.
So this is your third year doing this.
Yes.
And are you just as excited now as you were when you first started?
Oh, I am so excited. Yeah, it seems like it's getting easier and easier just because I'm making contacts and they're sort of like set in stone and becoming familiar with me instead of the former folks that were running it. But I still do get tons of help from Judy Mattson. She's a great lady in the community of Bonner, and she is kind of my silent sidekick. She's making some yummy soup for the event.
Cool.
So, yeah.
So is the name Hooked on Art actually kind of a pun?
Oh, yeah. Walter Hook, for those of you who don't know, he graduated from Bonner School, and all of my kids have been studying Walter Hook for the past couple weeks. He made this beautiful mural that's in our library.
I've seen it a couple times.
Yeah, actually, it lived in the cafeteria for a long time, and then I think as Walter sort of evolved into a more worthy artist and his artwork is worth more money, they cleaned it up and moved it to our library. But the mural is all about our school and how it was built. So if you look closely at it, it's all about the wood from the mill.
So not only is this a good way for kids and folks around Bonner and around surrounding areas, because we're in Missoula right now, and this is a great way for people to get hooked on art, to learn more about how some students learn art, be entertained, meet Jack Metcalf.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
Jack, that's okay.
Yeah. And if you haven't already seen him on your ballot. But you guys got to check it out, learn some history of some art as well as learning art in general. And you get to see, usually at a lot of these kinds of things, you see a bunch of kids and their art is also on display.
Yes, tons of art on display. And if you have not gotten a gift for your Valentine, come on out to the art market. Lavender Lori will be out there. We'll have chocolate. We'll have lots of amazing art, painting, photography. It's going to be a great afternoon day.
Cool. Yeah. So tell the folks here, when and where is this happening?
Okay, so this Saturday, the 11th, at Bonner School, 10 to 4. It's right off Highway 200, right across from the mill.
Great, and it's right near the train tracks.
Yep.
Definitely a nice little tribute to the mill as well, like being right across from the mill is the Bonner School. It's really easy to find. You can't miss it. It's like you're driving right through Bonner, and you'd be like, oh,
there it is.
There's the school.
There's lots of signage. There'll be signs all over. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
So is there anything different about this year compared to all the other years?
You know, I'm excited to meet Jack Metcalf. He's kind of made a name for himself in Missoula, and I haven't actually met him. We've just been emailing, and also knew the empanadas joint, my friend Salon, just coming out from her little restaurant on Main Street, and she'll be there from in our cafeteria from 11 to 2 selling empanadas.
Cool. And what is the kind of art that Jack does?
He does, I think he does mostly printmaking. I've heard that he has some amazing t-shirts. This is his work, Jack. Yep. Hip and funky and fun and cool.
Cool. All right, so if people want more information, where can they go?
Call Bonner School, 258-6151.
All right, well, thanks for joining me this morning. We'll be right back. I have a bunch of new MCAT original programming coming up for you right now.
And experiences. You know, as many of you all know, people who have support, community support, whether that's from an advocate, from a mentor, their faith community, are less likely to recidivate and return to jail or prison. They're also more likely to find employment and keep that employment, which in turn creates healthier, safer communities. We're employing people, we're keeping them from feeling like they need to commit new crimes to support their families. We're keeping people out of jails and prisons so we can keep families together. So these supportive relationships, in whatever form they come in, are really important to not only the individuals coming out of facilities, but also to the health of the community as a whole.
Aside from the fact that they often go back to prison, and prison is an expensive way to house people, is that leaving people on the street in Missoula is the very worst thing that we can do as a community. We can house almost anybody in this community for about $8,000 a year and provide them some sort of supportive services. If we don't house them, the average cost across the country and in Missoula of somebody being homeless on the streets is $25,000 to $50,000 a year. Right now, we have six guys downtown who have $100,000 bills at St. Patrick Hospital. I don't know whether any of those people were returning citizens or not, but when you leave people to fend for themselves on the street, what happens to them is they go to the jail and they go to the hospital. And those are really high-end financial instruments with which to deal with homeless people.
I always know where he is. And as for him, he's named the animals I wear around my belt. There's Axel and Wynn and Lobby and General Tuff and Red Eye. And after his mother, Sydney. And so we scavenge, have the various skirmishes that are unavoidable. Until it comes to pass that running ahead of some 12 or 15 zombies one afternoon, I have to wrench the belt around, jerk sideways on Sydney, my son reaching for her the whole time, which is, I suppose, where my son's rear view is perhaps not as ideal as it usually is. He has to watch the lead zombie lower its mouth to the cat he named, suckle it dry, but there's nothing for it. My legs are burning, my feet pounding, my front backpack lined with canned goods, and the sounds of our pursuers are more distant now. My son's slacking his quiver like I've taught him so as to preserve my balance. At least until a chance zombie, one of the fast ones, breaks from whatever it had been feeding on in the doorway. And of course, Sydney was our last animal. Now it's a race. The kind where I'm trying to be sure I really have saved one round in my left-hand pistol. The way I picture it is I'll round a corner, slide to a stop, swing my son around and pull his forehead to mine, hold us together like that. If I do it right, if the slug's got enough powder behind it, I can end us both with one shot. And if not, he'll be first anyway, and I'll be covered in him, and we'll have done everything we can do.
Every single time I feel fearful about something, you know, and my plan for my organization or business, I really have to sit there and ask myself, what are the things I can control in this, and what are the things I cannot control in this? And then I immediately focus, because every day I do things to grow my business. How can I generate revenue? You know, how can I enhance my value proposition? So I focus in on those things that I know are going to help me grow my business. And I just purposely take myself out of that. I have this honest conversation. What can I control? What can I not control? Go make some money, or go try to make some money today. Make a couple cold calls. Do something hard that, you know, you might have put off. But
Like today, most of my day is spent in meetings and reacting to employees. Mm. And you feel pretty useless because you're not making anything. You're just like saying yes or no to stuff. But at the end of the day, like how I sort of feel balanced is I'll just like write a line of code or I'll just do like one thing that adds up, that will eventually add up. And I won't leave the office until I like
get that one thing done. Yeah.
All right, guys. So that was all the stuff that's happening on MCAT. You can watch it anytime on MCAT.org. Here is a nice little I'm going to do a nice little shameless plug of my show. You can find out more information about Wake Up Missoula by logging on to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice for made you write it out twice and all that stuff. Here's my super awesome awkward face that you see right there as my thumbnail. You'll see this happening later on as well. You can see a whole bunch of videos and past interviews. You can see the interview that I had with Aaron Robinson later on in the show around here. You can't miss it. There, and of course, our Missoula Aging Services Senior Volunteering. You guys can totally check out that interview to learn more information about that. I got a new stop animation video for you guys in about a second. Here is MCAT.org. If you want to be a producer and be a part of MCAT and create your own story through MCAT, you can call us at 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. Orientation is tonight. It's starting at 5:30 at MCAT. 500 North Higgins, Suite 105. It's the Higgins building, but our entranceway is off of Spruce Street, directly across from Missoula Textile Service, and we're right next to Peak Fitness. So if you are, maybe if you want to do like a fitness video or whatever, you can come down and use this wonderful studio space to do so. Just a couple ideas just throwing around. It's orientation starting 5:30 tonight. On at MCAT, not on MCAT. I'm on MCAT channel, but at MCAT, the location, 500 North Higgins. More information, 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. That's just me plugging more of MCAT stuff. This Saturday is our stop animation, and we're going to be premiering a brand new fun little device called the Vive. And if you don't know what the Vive is, it is virtual reality. So MCAT just recently got a new virtual reality computer system. We put it in our art room, our old art room. It's a nice little device that utilizes, you plug it into a computer. It's a viewing device. You put it over your eyes, and it gives you that sense of being in a different place. So once you have that over your eyes, it senses your movement. So if you move left, the whole scenery that you see inside there also moves left. So everywhere you go, everything you see is based on your movements in this whole virtual reality world. And those are the nice little paddles, or these are the representation of your hands in the Vive. That is the motion capture device. So if you guys are standing in that room, you will be able to be part of it in two motion-controlled areas. So there's a nice little snippet of our Vive. And that's here. It's already here. And we're going to be hopefully showing the kids and all that stuff happening this Saturday from 1 to 5 p.m. $10 for any kids 9 to 13 who want to come and do some stop animation, live action, learn to make movies, learn to do some voiceovers, learn everything you need to know about MCAT in terms of making movies and creating a story through a visual medium that is MCAT. Thank you, guys. There is a nice little orientation short I want to show you guys. This is will be part of the main orientation video that you guys will be seeing tonight, and when we come back, I'll have all your events happening the next 2 days.
Here's the deal: if you want a series on MCAT, if you want a series and that series is pre-recorded, you have to make 3 of them just so we know that we're going to have at least 3. Now, if somebody just has one show, our guarantee is that it will run at least twice. We do charge nominal annual user and training fees at MCAT. $20 a year for your annual user fee.
Right.
You get to use MCAT all year long for $20. $20 a one-time training fee. A lot of people who say they can't afford that $40 fee can volunteer at MCAT. Our volunteer rate is fairly generous. It's $10 an hour equivalent. So if you want to use MCAT and pay all your fees in the form of volunteering, then you could volunteer for 4 hours. And then subsequent years, you just volunteer for 2 hours.
All right, welcome back. That was a nice little snippet of our orientation video about how you can get involved with MCAT and also how you can volunteer with MCAT to take some of that, our user annual fee, kind of take that down a peg. Moving on. Here are some of your events that are happening here and around Missoula. Wednesday, learn how to write a modern resume at MBN. So the owner of Career Connections, Lynn Tellerico, will discuss how to write a modern resume to excite current and prospective employers, clients, and customers at the Missoula Businesswomen's Network General Meeting, held Wednesday tomorrow at noon at the Doubletree in Missoula. The meeting is open to all members as well as to any non-members who are attending, who have not attended the two previous MBN meetings as well. Julie Richter came on and she talked about the Missoula Businesswomen's Network. They had a little symposium happening at the Hilton Garden Inn, and they were talking all about this. A discussion with the ACA, Affordable Care Act, at Jakers today at noon. They have Dan Keith, CEO of It Starts With Me Health, and Richard Mittenberger, CEO of InterWest Health. They'll talk about the Affordable Care Act and its effects on consumers, employers, and the healthcare system. This is a very timely topic, and the representatives in Washington, D.C. are tasked with modifying the ACA in the near future. All of us are impacted in some way by this legislation, as well as the changes to it. So if you guys are who did take the Affordable Care Act, and who I think that there was a whole little like window that closed for a lot of people who were doing kind of last minute things while the things were changing. This is a good way to get more information about it. There's a lot going on with it, and there are a lot of calls going into a Congress saying that why should we repeal something without replacing something? But you know, it's politics. That's just politics. And you guys can learn about this. It's at 12 o'clock. They're talking about the Affordable Care Act and other subsequent healthcare issues, along with other healthcare things involved, how it affects your healthcare. So just learn a little bit more, become a little more educated about just healthcare in general. Conceal Reveal is a mask making workshop hosted by the Living Art of Montana. So Living Art of Montana is a great organization that helps people who are dealing with terminal illnesses, help them on the road to recovery, but at the same time also help them ease their pain through a nice little kind of gets people's minds off of their ailments and their illnesses to make art in this mask form. So throughout history, masks have been made to entertain, hide, and protect, and transform. In Conceal Reveal, they'll use the process of mask making as members to discover and express different aspects of ourselves. A registration is required, offered free of charge for adults 18 and up dealing with illness or loss. No experience necessary. Any questions, you can call them at 549-5329. Living Art is a place to create, share, and heal. This is happening from 2 to 4 p.m. for Wednesday starting today. So it's happening every single Wednesday for the next 4 weeks from 2 to 4. Global Public Health Lecture Series is starting tonight at 6:30 p.m., a lecture on the Global Health Service Partnership, a novel approach to addressing human resources for health. And it's by Linda Jacobson, CNM, CFNP, MPH, Deputy Chief Nursing Officer, SEED Global Health. This event is open to the public and is free to attend. And it's going to be at the University of Montana Gallagher Business Building. I believe it's in room 123. 123, Gallagher Business Building. That's usually where they have it. I've shot it before in the past. I believe MCAT will be shooting it, so you can see it on MCAT later on. Maybe I'll get a clip from Ron. Who knows? You just never know with me. I'm crazy. and of course, here are some of your music events happening. Actually, scratch that. Educational events being featured at the Missoula Public Library. Here's all your public library events happening. You got open hours at the Makerspace starting at 10 a.m. Windows 10. So if you guys don't know about Windows 10, you can go to the public library to learn all about it today at 12:30. Afternoon matinee movie. They're doing a movie at the Missoula Public Library. It's free to attend. It starts at 2 p.m. and I believe it'll be in the large meeting room. Middle school writers group will be at the public library at 3:30 p.m. Second Wednesday book group will be at 7 p.m. tonight at the Missoula Public Library. Here are your music events happening. Sharing the Groove, Creating a Groove with the Music of Fish. Yesterday, they usually do like the Grateful Dead, but this one's during, this is the Music of Fish, their happy hour. It happens at 4:30 to about 6:30, and you guys get a little punch card. So you guys can, if you fill out a punch card, you can go to a one of the shows at the Top Hat, limited to maybe not the one. Imagine Jam Society Public Jam. So it's an open bluegrass jam band thing. So you get to hang out, play some music. Country Dance Lessons with instructor Kathy Clark is tonight at the Sunrise Saloon. Karaoke Contest at the Eagles Lodge. Craptastic Karaoke at the Badlander. Mill Crate Wednesday at the Palace. Rocking Karaoke at the Sunrise Saloon. And ESP Open Mic at the VFW. So those are all your Wednesday events. Now I'm going to move on and talk everything you need to know about your Thursday events. And then I promise you I will have my stop animation video for you guys as well. I'm just checking the time. That's why I look right. Yeah, I'm good. Thursday, there's the 2017 Western Montana Grazing and Agriculture Conference at the Doubletree. It's starting tomorrow morning at 8 a.m., so you guys gonna want to have to wake up early. This is February 9th and 10th at the Doubletree Hotel in Missoula. Livestock and crop producers, as well as natural resource professionals and educators from across Montana, will converge for a two-day event. The focus of the conference is to continue the conversation of sustainability, profitability, and environmentality. Oh man, there's a lot of like added on letters that maybe not actually make sense. But regardless of that, the cost to attend is $50 before. Actually, it's $75. Like, it's too late. You guys can't do a pre-register fee. It's $75 to get in there. Registration includes light breakfast, lunch, and heavy hors d'oeuvres. Thursday night at the Kettle House Brewing North in Missoula. Register online at Lake County ConservationDistrict.org or call Heidi at 406-676-28. Oh, I'm just gonna make this big for you guys, so I don't have to say it all, because it's there's a lot of numbers, a lot of information for you guys. Here is a nice little representation of it: Lake County Conservation District.org, or call Heidi Fleury, 406-676-2841, extension 102. So if you're watching this online, I suggest you do a screen capture or just pause it, so you can check that out. It's all about Montana Grazing and Agriculture Conference. You get to learn all the new things about ranching, open range ranching, agriculture, and all sorts of wonderful things, especially in this time in our area. Because if you're not a rancher in eastern Montana, if you haven't heard the news over the last couple of years, there have been some weather issues with some of the ranches, actually some of the farms, where they've had to deal with some hail, some crops were destroyed. So it's just one of the things that you can always discuss as well. That especially in Montana, because we are not only, because we're very heavily into ranching and farming. That's a nice little conference to go to. Doubletree Hotel, starting tomorrow at 8 a.m. and it's going to go for 2 days. Moving on, tomorrow, riding coach training at the Loman Center. Ooh, man. When I was in college, I could say that without even thinking about it. But now I'm just like, ugh. But of course, Riding Coaches of Missoula provides volunteer riding coaches to public school students in Missoula and Ravalli counties. They meet with every student one-on-one during this class period, on classroom writing assignments, with emphasis on the idea that and critical thinking. All coaches must attend a 3-hour training session. Registration is required. Next up is Mud Valentine's Workshop, the League of Flowers, at 6 p.m. Home Resource Education Room, which is the second floor of the Home Resource, if you don't know where that is. Join Melissa, owner of Earth Within Flowers, for a festive pre-Valentine's Day workshop to rediscover the meaning of flowers while creating a custom dried arrangement for yourself and a loved one. Well, they'll provide beautiful stationery at your disposal and transcribe your message. So this would be a nice little pre-Valentine's thing. If you guys are planning on anything, that's tomorrow night at 6 p.m. Here are all your public libraries events happening tomorrow. Tiny Tales. It's happening at 10:30 a.m. They do story readings and finger plays for kids birth to 36 months, I believe. Make It and Take It Thursdays at Big Sky. So Big Sky Branch Library, they do like an arts and crafts type of thing, and I'm assuming they're emphasizing Valentine's Day as well. And you guys can do that. It starts at 2:30 tomorrow. It also involves... because it's early out, they can start earlier. So 2:30, I believe it's going to be at the Big Sky High School, and you guys can totally check that out. Lego Club is at 3:30 p.m. as well on Thursday. And that pretty much wraps up all your public library events in that. Also, in terms of music events for your Thursday, February 9th, you have Galactic and the Bright Light Social Hour at the Wilma Theater. Nice little music, funk, rock band. Country Dance Out with Kathy Clark again. So if you don't want to go see a concert at the Wilma, you can go see Kathy Clark. You can go to live jazz at Plonk. They just started doing some live jazz at the Plonk. So it's nice to know that they're going to be picking up because they did Jazz Martini Night at the Ballad on Sundays, which they totally just stopped doing. So Plonk is... in a way, taking up the mantle for some jazz here in Missoula. Open mic at the Broadway, rocking karaoke at Dark Horse. There's Faster Rabbit and Friends live music at VFW. You have Top Hat Lounge is doing some bluegrass music called The Workers. And just for you guys who are who used to do the Thursday night Badlander Dead Hipster thing, they have a new DJ who's going to be starting on Thursday night. It's going to be Trevor Pressler, who is a... if you don't remember, he usually does a lot of breakdancing in and around town. He's part of a nice little dance hip crew, and he'll be headlining the Thursday night dance nights as a DJ and probably even dance as well. So you guys can look forward to that as well for your Thursday events. Thanks for joining me this morning. Right now I have a nice stop animation video for you guys, and it's called Comic Relief. So without further ado, here is the premiere of my brand new stop animation movie.
Hi, would you like anything to drink before the show?
No, thank you.
How about you?
Yeah, I'll have a...
Captain Panikin would like service, please. Right now. Will you stop screwing around? Hold on to your swords!
Would you guys keep it down? We're about to start the show.
Now you listen here, kid. You just gotta follow my lead. You're gonna be okay.
Yeah, it's been a while. I'm a little rusty.
Yeah, like I haven't heard that one before.
Hey, boys. Good luck out there.
I've been doing this for 3 months.
Yeah, new town... new sense of humor.
Connor, you will do great.
Yeah, don't worry about it. I've got your back no matter what.
You guys have been so supportive.
I'm so nervous for you.
You guys are too cute.
What did you say?
He thinks we're cute.
Yar, rum?
Start the show!
Just when we need a revolving door at the prison.
Excuse me, the show's about to start. Shut up.
Everybody, are you guys ready to laugh? We got a lot of great comedians coming on the show.
Let them out already.
Well, it looks like we got a couple pirates in the audience tonight. Looks like you guys might have to, you know, watch your booty. Very good. I'm not here to tell you guys any jokes, but I am here to introduce you to my best friend and funny man, Rusty.
Gotta do my breathing exercises, huh? I went to buy coffee at a local coffee the other day, and not only did they take forever, well, actually, technically, I should be getting service any time after this set. Buy local. Wait, local. Let me tell you about this
Hey, dude, what's
you?
Up?
I mean, this coffee that's supposed to give you a kick that needs to get you through the day, I wish I could kick your booty.
Connor, I think you need to go out there right now.
Sorry, this
isn't
my day.
Do you think you can save this set? I need you right now.
I have a friend who was just beat up by a statue the other day. Oh, thank you.
Sorry about that, folks.
Yarr, get on with it.
Make him walk the play out.
Why do you keep that bird, sir? I don't know if I can do this.
Listen, you're the funniest person I know. I love you.
You always have my back.
Good luck.
All right, guys. I'd like to introduce you to Connor. Good luck out there, kid. Yo, dude.
Shut up. Nail some faces.
Thanks, Rusty. It's great to be here. I'm Connor, and apparently I'm supposed to tell you jokes or whatever. I think we'll have to update the two drink minimum to something a little harder.
That's my boy.
Luckily for us, we got pirate gang members to supply us with everything we need to make bad decisions.
Where did he get this guy? He's hilarious.
He's one of a kind.
One thing's for sure is he's headlining from here on out.
Okay, so just so you know, just a little context. It's just I'm trying to like move the story forward a little bit more, and like he just basically told one joke. You know, like if you tell one really good joke, doesn't mean you should start headlining jokes. Everything aside, there is my stop motion video of the week, part of my Scott Ramp stop motion anthology, which will continue next week with something that I've lovingly titled XS. Ugh, darn it, I have to say this again. Next week, I have a title called Escalation, so you guys can look forward to that for my next stop animation video of the week. Thanks again to Aaron Robertson for joining me this morning. Hooked on Art is happening this Saturday at Bonner Milltown School, so it's going to be from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m., all art, all day. Jack Metcalf, artist, and he also ran for Justice of the Peace. If you haven't seen him on his ballot, he's an artist who does a lot of cool little designs, and I believe some of the designs that you see right here are also inspired by Jack Metcalf as well. Ooh, darn. Okay, so thank you guys for joining me this morning. Thank to Aaron Robertson for being a part of my morning show this morning. Check out some art. It's happening this Saturday. There's a lot going on here. And also, AMCAD has a new Vive. So if you guys want to come on down and check out our new virtual reality setup, you can totally do that, because I'm going to be totally doing that all day today. So for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ramp. Thank you all for joining me.